There's the face-off. The game is on. First few minutes of the play is featured by long shots and close checking. Two teams are certainly stepping on it right from the start. Here go the Leafs. Cotton rushes into the corner after the puck. He goes back of Lauren Chabot, coming over on this wing. Lucky's at the blue line. At center ice, Primo with him, relays the pass, and it's intercepted by Seibert. Seibert rushes down the far boards, is turned around, centers over to Bun Cook. Bun Cook slaps at it, and the Leafs again break with Primo at center ice. On the far wing over to Day. Day shoots, and Aikenhead clears it into the corner over to Ching Johnson. Period is nearly over. First period is now over, and no score. New York Rangers, nothing. Toronto Maple Leafs, nothing. During this intermission, let's go down to the Maple Leaf hockey team's dressing room and meet the team. Let's go.
Great work in the first period. Connie, how about it? Do you think they can do the trick tonight?
Well, they're doing the best they can, Foster, and whether they win or lose, they'll play like champions.
There. Can do it, eh?
Yes.
How about you, Dick? Dick, you've coached the Chicago Blackhawks and the Toronto Maple Leafs for 2 years. You certainly know your hockey players. And what do you consider, which is the best team, the Toronto Maple Leafs of last year or this year's edition?
Well, I think this year's team is about the gamest bunch of athletes I ever had any connection with. Owing to so many injuries, while the boys are putting up a wonderful battle.
How does it feel to be called a bad man, Red?
Oh, there's nothing I can do about it, Foster. I get it anyway.
You know what? Is amazing to most people, the fact that you can play hockey and play defense at that and do a good job of it with a broken hand. How can you protect that hand from the wear and tear of a hockey game?
Well, Dr. Rush has fixed up a cast, a plaster Paris cast for me, Foster. It reaches from my elbow down to my knuckles. It only allows me to grip the stick between my thumb and the cast, but proves out quite satisfactory.
And King, are you bumping them all okay?
Well, we're doing our best, Foster. I think that we can beat them.
King, you're one of the veteran stars of the National Hockey League. Just how many playoff games have you taken part in?
I've been in 10 playoff games, Foster, been playing 12 years.
What would you consider the hardest series you've ever been in?
The hardest series, I think, is the present series.
That's great. Pusher, how about it? How did it feel when you scored that goal in Boston?
Pretty good, Foster.
Charlie, it's conceded that you have the hardest shot of the National Hockey League. I think a lot of people would be very interested to know just how you hold your stick. How do you get them away so fast?
Well, I hold a stick just about the same as anyone else, Foster, but I think I snap it away with my wrist a little quicker.
All right, gang, come on now. Let's go. Come on, come on. Come on. Come on.
Off again. Bill Toms over to Jackson. Jackson is checked. Rangers getting possession at center, and a long shot goes into the corner. Puck is back of the Toronto nets. Another Toronto rush at the blue line. Bill Toms reaches center ice, trying to get by his check, is finally stopped and chased back to his own blue line. He keeps on going back. Boucher is following in after him. Back of the nets. Now he's breaking fast. Coming up the blue line at center, Buescher rushes in on this wing, into the corner, centers it out, a scramble, and Aikenhead cleared nicely. The Toronto team right in on top of them. Rangers are being hard-pressed at this stage. They're trying to get it out of their zone. They finally shoot it down the ice. It's in Toronto territory, into the corner. There's a face-off on an offside. Away they go again. The Leafs start fast, center ice. Levinsky crosses the Ranger blue line, Ching Johnson knocking him out of the play. And the Rangers send two men up at center ice, crossing over on this wing, the blue line, into the corner. They hem him in there, knock him down, and Harold Cotton sits on him just to make sure he doesn't get up. Cody Cleghorn stepped over there. The Leafs from the faceoff carry it up the ice, in back of the Ranger nets. Rangers shoot it down the ice. It stopped at the defense, and the Leafs keep crowding the New York team. They finally got it away.
Second period is now over, and there's still no score. Rangers, nothing. Toronto Maple Leafs, nothing. What do you say we go down to the Ranger dressing room and see the team and also meet their famous coach, Lester Patrick?
I'll keep on going the way we are.
Good boy, Andy. That's stopping me, boy.
There's a couple over there. Say, Lester, how is hockey going over in the United States?
Well, Foster, I tell you, it's remarkable the way the game of hockey has been accepted into the hearts of the great American centers. And I honestly believe that its possibilities have merely been scratched.
Well, certainly the Rangers have increased the popularity of the game in New York. How would you really rate their Rangers of this year with other years?
Well, in my opinion, the Ranger team of 1932-33 is the most crowd-pleasing, colorful, and polished machine that's ever been my pleasure to handle.
That's quite a tribute. I guess I'll see Ching Johnson now.
Yes, Ching's just around the corner.
Ching, what's the hardest series you've been in the playoffs?
Well, I think the series of 1928 with the Montreal Maroons, the hardest series I've ever in.
You're certainly a veteran of veteran. I believe you've been picked on the All-Star team for 3 years, is it?
Yes.
Which city would you sooner play in?
Well, I think I'd rather play in Montreal than any city.
Where are those cooks? I have to find them.
They're back here in the corner.
Are you two cooks still together? You know, it's amazing to hockey fans how you can work together the way you do. How do you really do it?
Well, we get along pretty well together, being brothers. We played together for 11 years, 6 years before we came to the New York Rangers, and since then, we've got along wonderfully well.
Bill, surely you have a few hints to the younger hockey players. You know how you drill them in there and have led the league so many times. Couldn't you give the youngsters just a few tips how to put them in there?
Well, the only thing I can say to the youngsters coming up is to put the puck where the goaltender is.
That's quite
There's
good.
The bell, boys. Come on, last period.
I guess I'll have to go to work, too.
Lots of luck,
boys. Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Another face-off at the Toronto blue line. They're away at center. Primo lost the puck. And Siebert goes back of his own defense, then back of the nets, starting a rush, a dangerous one at that, at his own blue line. Center ice, blue line again. He's crashed at the defense by Levinsky. Archibald clearing it back to Primo. Primo in the corner, rushing up alone at his blue line. Keeps right on, although he's checked several times. Into the corner, and his shot was wide. From the corner, Ching Johnson rushes up. Dangerous rush with a little over 12 minutes to go. Another face-off at the Toronto defense. The Leafs cleared away. Center ice. Rangers getting it again. Von Cook on the far wing is stopped. The Leafs at center ice. Cross the blue line. Primo is forced into the corner. Centered out. And Aikenhead was knocked over in the barrel. Rangers rush up on the far wing. Bill Cook at center ice over the blue line. Stopped at the defense, but the Rangers keep right on coming in. It's close, but it was wide of the net. Red Horner leads a dangerous rush for Toronto. They're closing right in on the defense, three of them. Right in close, and Sands is upset, and Aikenhead falls over. That was close for the Rangers. Crowd certainly worked up to this game. Another close call for Rangers. Primo back of the net, centers it out, and 1 minute to go, and that's closer than ever. Another Toronto, a ganging attack, and they miss, going into the corner. Crowd on their feet by this time, crowding around the Ranger nets. Rangers down this side. Keeling goes into the corner, loses it. Puck is back of the Toronto nets, and they're having a hard time now keeping it away. Andy Blair rushes up with Gracie, is outskated at center. And the regulation time is nearly up. They've come to the end of the 60 minutes of regulation play, and the score is still tied, nothing. That means overtime, and the first goal will win the game. They're all ready for the face-off now. Where they go for the overtime. Doherty steps in there fast, took his shot, but was wide. The puck in the corner. The Leafs close in fast, but Rangers shot it down and is called back. Face-off. Gracie nearly got clear. Bill Cook down this wing for Rangers at center. Over the blue line, in on the defense, pass to the open wing, and no one was there to take it. Clancy of the Leafs rushing up the blue line at center. They go closing in fast. Four of them right in on the defense. Into the corner, and Aikenhead pulled off a great stop. That was close. The Leafs are trying to center it out. Rangers trying to get it away. Finally, They shoot it down the ice, and the crowd had quite a thrill over that. Into the corner, the Leafs back of their own nets are two men short. The Rangers, Bill Cook, score. The series is over. The New York Rangers are the winners. The battered old Stanley Cup goes back to Broadway, emblematic of the world's professional championships.